أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Today the topic we are going to be discuss is the very common problem of our society that is the sexual offenses So daily we think and we saw these problems why these are occurring the mainly the their causation is due to the is very common and it are mainly the three important factors influencing the human sexual behavior and it is a very complicated subject and it requires a careful analysis of these factors in behavior of a human being these are the first of all is the necessity of sex and second is the normal and socially accepted manner to fulfill this necessity and third is the abnormal and socially unacceptable sexual behavior now the first is the necessity of sex अल्लाह ताला ने जैसे जोड़े बनाए हैं हमेशा से जैसे एक सिलसिला चला आ रहा है तो उसी तरह से अकॉर्डिंग टू द मेडिकल साइंसेस इट इज़ एन इंट्रेंसिक एंड कंपल्सिव रिक्वायरमेंट अमंग्स ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दैट मस्ट बी फुलफिल्ड एंड नॉर्मल एंड सोशली एक्सेप्टेड मैनर टू फुलफिल दिस नेसेसिटी इज द ओनली द मैरिज which is defined in a conference at Boston University that normal sexual activity may be defined as an adult sexual expression with an adult of the opposite sex with mutual respect tenderness and love and the marriage therefore has been accepted as the right way of having sexual intercourse with the partner of opposite sex and having the mutual respect tenderness and love so being muslims we are thankful that we are muslims and the only the marriage is the socially accepted behavior to fulfill this necessity while the abnormal and socially unacceptable sexual behavior is not accepted because as a human sexual behavior is an extremely personal and confidential affair no one knows about all what he is thinking and what he his social life is going on the majority of people have sexual intercourse in the natural way and that too after their marriage while a small percentage of people adopts unnatural or perverted ways so that's why that is known as the sexual offenses so ye zarur aana hota hai so the definition of sexual offenses will be these are the acts of the illegal sex sexual intercourse with a second person or with animals while sexual perversions are acts intended to result in sexual gratification without sexual intercourse these are due to psychological illnesses which requires treatment or moral degradations which required punishment so the classification we classify the sexual behavior in as a natural way unnatural way and natural way is further defined as legal sex that is after marriage and illegal sex that is zina it is further divided in depends upon the attempting of the sexual offense zina rape and fornication and third is the incest that is the sex with prohibited relations while unnatural way is the homosexuality and heterosexuality होमो मीन्स विद सेम सेम पर्सन सेम दैट इज़ द सोडोमी एंड लेस्बियनिज्म वाइल हेट्रोसेक्सुअलिटी इज़ विद द अपोजिट सेक्स दैट इज नोन एज द पीडोफीलिया एंड बेस्टेलिटी. So today I will discuss here is the, as already we have discussed the laws of marriage and what are the statute laws of the marriage in our society, and today we will discuss the illegal sex. Before discussing the illegal sex, there are the sexual perversions. In these, the persons feel sexual gratification without doing the sexual intercourse by means of their behavior, by means of their attitude with opposite persons. They gratify sexually because of the psychological illnesses. These include sadism, masochism, exhibitionism, transsexualism, transvestism, voyeurism, fetishism and necrophilia. We will discuss all these one by one later on, because they can be asked by the teachers, examiners in Viva, or there may be, they can be comes in SCQs as a short notes. So natural sex, as I already told, that is, it may be legal, illegal and incest. Legal sex, it is a sex which is done after validly married to each other, and marriage should be after puberty, being male 18 years and female 16 years. And if it is with relatives, then it should be with permissible relatives. Now the natural sexual offenses, that is the illegal, it is the rape is the most serious sexual offense. It can only be committed by a biological male, and it is redefined in the Criminal Justice and Public Order Act 1994 as non-consensual penetration of the vagina by a penis. And sexual intercourse is no longer part of the definition of rape, having been replaced by the term penetration. The use of this term reflects that any degree of penile insertion, even if this is only just between the labia, neither full penetration nor ejaculation is necessary, along with rupture of the hymen, is irrelevant, because just the intention is sufficient for the allegation of the sexual offense. दे दो सुन लेगी सो भी आप सुन लेना आएगा अगर तो. सो द मेडिकल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द विक्टिम एंड असेलिएंट लॉज हैज क्लियरली डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन लीगल एंड इलीगल सेक्सुअल इंटरकोर्स विद डिस्टिंक्शंस ऑफ वेदर डन पर वजाइना और रेक्टम. ए फीमेल मे बी वायोलेटेड एट बोथ द वजाइनल एंड एनल ओरिफिसेस एंड इवन इन द माउथ. सो द मेडिकल एग्जामिनेशन शुड नॉट बी लिमिटेड एट वन रीजन and will depend upon the allegation, and it is joint responsibility of law enforcement and medical authorities for the collection of evidence for the scene till final interpretations or findings of medical examination. And no age is immune for the victim. A victim may have injuries on other parts of the body even when the episode is consented, and in genital regions, especially in virgin females. So the medical examination of the victim and the offender should be done immediately after obtaining written consent. It should be thorough, complete in all respects, and conducted in good order, along with collection necessary specimens, because the outcome of criminal case will depends upon it. And the protocol of the examination is it is similar for male and female, but female victim is usually brought first. And whenever the suspect becomes available, the same doctor should examine him. Procedural steps for the medical examination of the victim. As in a routine, we already do in a medico-legal examination in other cases. First of all, the pre-examination, the consent, biodata information and establishment of the personal identity by taking her ID card and by confirming her identity by the relatives. And next, the most important thing is the history. History includes the general and obstetric. If she is married, then obstetric history, that how many she has, how many babies and married since how long. And if unmarried, then the important thing is the what is the age of menarche and what is her last menstrual period. And then the specific history is regarding the allegation. Next is the general impressions, that is the dress, makeup and mental status. By general impression, by general examination of the victim, we can assess that whether he is really have had sexual intercourse or whether he is raped or she has willingly done this act. And before the examination, we have to examine the examination of the clothes. By undressing the clothes, if the clothes are same that was the dress was wearing at the time of the incident, and examining them, conditioning of the clothes and trace evidence any present on them. And then examination of the body, general examination, systemic examination and genital examination. General examination, we assess that the age of the victim, his her vitals and general injuries if present on other parts of the body. And systemic, all other generally just examining that her respiration and her heart sounds are normal. Genital examination is the most important. In this we examine the genitalia, anal canal and presence of the any foreign bodies. So we have to examine whole of the pelvis to collect the evidence. And then after examination, we have to collection of the specimens from the clothes, from the body and from the genitalia. So the important examination is the genital examination of the victim, most important step of all the examination. For this we have to make proper position of the female victim, that is the lithotomy position, lying flat on the table, properly equipped place for the best results. Light should be adequate. In an implement for the examination are table, lamp, surgical gloves, magnifying lens, spatulas of the various sizes, swab applicators and glycerin glass rod, test tubes and containers to collect the evidence. So the special examination is in four stages. Special examination, inspection as a routine, as we do in other examinations. First we examine by visually inspection. Findings, bilateral traction, digital examination and instrumental or specular examination. Inspection is the findings around and under the vulva. Pay special attention to the condition of the labia, mons pubis and the adjacent parts of the thighs or to note any redness, swelling, lesions, bleeding or discharge from the vulva. Injuries such as bruises or scratches, stains and loose hairs should be collected. The pubic hair looks for the soiled or matted. Now, bilateral traction, by doing the bilateral traction, we can easily examine the vaginal orifice and the condition of the hymen. Its edges of the hymen may be straight, irregular, folded or fimbriated. Lacerations of the hymen can be elicited by placing both thumbs at 3 and 9 o'clock position and applying lateral traction to the introitus. This stretches the hymen at 6 and 12 o'clock position, so tears at these areas becomes easily visible. An examination is facilitated by use of glistakine glass rod by placing the lit end of the rod on the inner side of the hymen and move along the edges. And it is useful in differentiating recent from old tears. The translucency of the hymen becomes brighter at the site of old tears and is slightly blurred if the tear is bleeding. Tears due to sexual intercourse are complete and situated posterolaterally. This is the very important point, that tears at the introitus, which are due to the forceful sexual intercourse, they are usually situated posterolaterally. And if the victim is virgo intacta, digital and instrumental examination must not be performed, and we have to finish our examination here and after collection of the evidence from the introitus. Digital examination, it is done to guess the size, tone, any tenderness and laxity of the vaginal canal. The extent of laxity assessed whether it admits easily one or more fingers. The difference of tone and extent of rugosities is an index to differentiate habituated vagina from non-habituated ones. And lastly, the secular examination is performed only in married and sexually experienced women. By using appropriate size speculum, inspecting the vaginal mucosa, its rogginess, and to locate any bleeding, injury or any other condition of the vaginal mucosa. The cervical portion of the uterus can also be inspected. And after examination, we have to certify the findings. Certification of the sexual offences is done only if the cases are brought by police and by the court orders. And we have to certify whether the findings are consistent with sexual intercourse or they are otherwise. Documentation of findings is mandatory. All the findings should be documented as written record. Reports on collected material and other assets must be placed in order. And forensic medical certificate, as you know, is prepared in triplicate on specific pro forma by the duty doctor in her own writing and sign. Of the three certificates made, the original stays in the register. One of the top copies is handed over to the police officer after obtaining signature on the original, and the other one is sent to statistical section for compiling the criminal data. Medical certificate should include both positive and negative findings. The opinion must be based on the recorded data. If clinical findings are present, then it should be certified accordingly, stating that the medical examination findings are consistent with the allegation. And when we receive the reports from the chemical examiner, the evidence we have collected, then if they, although they are not stained with semen, swabs are not stained with semen, then also we cannot exclude that the sexual intercourse has not been taken place. But if you have clinical findings, so you must write that the medical examination findings are consistent with the allegation. Thank you very much.